Ida Haendel was signed to the Decca Record Company as a teenage refugee prodigy in 1940. She was signed by one of Decca's legendary A&R men, Harry Sarton. Ida had arrived not that long before to live in London as a refugee with her parents from Poland, and she became a student of Carl Flesch, one of his last students, as a matter of fact. Her training was so complete and her playing was so amazingly mature that no one could believe that this was a girl barely into her teens, but she was. She had the misfortune, I think, in retrospect, of making the bulk of her virtuoso prodigy records during the Second World War, and it was very, very difficult for England to export anything like recordings outside of the shores. So by the time the end of the war came, Ida Haendel was no longer a blushing teenager, but she was a fully mature artist, a young woman. And I would imagine the fashion of the day had passed on to the flowering of talent after the Second World War. And Ida, for very complicated reasons, left Decca at the end of 1947. But in those 7 years, she made some absolutely amazing recordings. The concerto recordings are wonderful. They suffer a little bit from rather constricted sound and sometimes not the most inspired orchestral accompaniment. But where Ida's great genius comes to the fore is in the wealth of solo material she recorded with piano, with a variety of accompanists, including few with your wonderful pianist, Noel Mutton Wood, her sister, as well as some of the celebrated other accompanist types of her time. Those records were 78 RPM records, and when Decca was sold to Polygram in 1980, there was a big clean out of all sorts of storage spaces. The studios were sold, a lot of things were consolidated. And very sadly, and I'm told somewhat mysteriously, a lot of the old metal masters from the 78 RPM era simply disappeared. And so the Ida Haendel recordings that appear on this marvelous reissue disc that is a companion to her new recordings were all gathered with the kind assistance of the Gramophone magazine and the library of the BBC. I knew Ida Haendel from my time in Boston, one of the first artists to come and play with the Boston Symphony Orchestra after I joined at the end of 1994 and the beginning of 1995, was Ida Haendel. She'd been engaged to play the Brahms Violin Concerto with her dear friend and advocate, Simon Rattle. Now, Ida Haendel was no longer a young woman by anybody's estimation, but she, when I met her for the very first time, reminded me of the dictum that every artist must live by if they are to remain fresh, and that Ida Haendel has never let the child in her die. A sense of wonder about her approach to performance, a sense of rightness about what she is doing, supreme self-confidence as a musician, and a twinkle in her eye. Ida will be forever young, whatever the calendar says, and amazingly so, well now into her 70s, she has retained the freshness of youth, both in her playing, but the great maturity of an artist who's been before the public for 60 of her 70 plus years. Ida did not perform with Simon Rattle on that occasion because Simon had to bow out of the engagement. His wife at the time was giving birth to their second child. Instead, Klaus-Peter Flohr conducted. And Ida and I spent a fair amount of time getting to know one another, and I knew some of her recordings from her EMI era, but I hadn't heard her play ever live. And of course, the result was an absolute revelation. When you are confronted with a great artist for the first time live, it is still something that takes your breath away. We stayed in touch. And when I came to the Decca Record Company, I began to do some research. I never really knew that Ida Haendel was a Decca artist. And one day I was just rifling through archives and I came across her name and the list of her recordings, and I was flabbergasted. Almost simultaneous to that, Vladimir Ashkenazi phoned me and said, "Evans, I have just played in Berlin with Ida Haendel, a concerto. I want to tell you with my hand on my heart, anything you want me to record with this lady, I will gladly do." And I said, "Well, that's very ironic, Volva, because, of course, she has made records for Decca before, but 50 years ago. And he said, "Then we must. We absolutely must make a new recording." I said, "Well, I'd like to make a record of violin and piano music, not a concerto. Because a concerto, not only is it expensive, but it does not really show the greatest variety an artist can bring." And Volva was, of course, since he is a phenomenal pianist as well as a wonderful conductor, said, "I'd gladly do it." And we picked the record very, very carefully to give a sense of cohesion to both who Ida is as an artist and where she's come from. So naturally, Szymanowski, the great Polish compatriot composer, had to be on the recording. Enescu, who was one of her teachers, had to be on the recording. And because she has such a gypsy in her soul, we figured that we could not have a record complete without some music of Bartok. We also came up with the idea at the time that no one had heard ever this sort of comparison of Ida today and Ida at the very beginning of her career. And although some of the 78 RPM recordings have been issued on various other labels, they'd never been reissued on Decca. With Ida's help, we sat down and reviewed every single one of her older recordings we could find. And this is her personal selection. And it is, I think, for anybody who will hear it, a revelation. With no disrespect to the young prodigies of today, Ida Haendel was a great artist from the very beginning of her career. And I'm very happy to say, with this new recording, it shows that she still is, 6 decades later.